Good morning, children. Children, you know we are studying about relations. So before proceeding the question, let us recapitulate relation. Suppose A is any non-empty set. A be any non-empty set. Then every subset. Then subset R of A cross A, that is R is subset of A cross A, is called a relation. R is relation. Then we have discussed about equivalence relation. So for equivalence relation, we must have three conditions. The first one is reflexive. Reflexive means A is related to A, or element A belongs to R. For all A belongs to A. This is symbol for all. The second one was symmetry. Symmetry means if AB belongs to R or A related to B, then BA also belongs to R. This is symmetry condition. For all AB belongs to A. And finally, transitive relation means if AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R, then AC also belongs to R. For all ABC belongs to A. If R is a set such that it satisfies all the three conditions, that is reflexive, symmetry and transitive, then it is called equivalence relation. Last day, means yesterday, we have done one problem. So let us proceed to some other question. Let Z is set of all integers. This is your question. Let Z is the set of all integers, and a relation R. Relation R defined on Z. As defined by R is equals to AB, such that A minus B is even. Prove that R is an equivalence relation on Z. So children, see, first of all, it is given that Z is the set of all integers and R is a relation. So relation R is already given on Z, and R is AB, means R is a set which contains those elements like AB whose difference, means A minus B, is even. So we have to prove R is an equivalence relation. For equivalence relation, you know, we will prove reflexive, symmetry and transitive. Reflexive is basically for two similar elements. So see first reflexive. Zero. You know zero is an integer, so zero belongs to Z. So zero is even or odd. First of all, check whether zero is even number, because zero lies between 1 and minus 1. 1 is odd, minus 1 is odd, and between 2 odds, 1 even always exists. So 0 is even number. And you know, 0 is equals to difference of 2 similar number or 2 same number. So A minus A is also even. For all A belongs to Z, A minus A is also even. So what is given? A minus B is even, then AB belongs to R. Accordingly, this A minus A is even, we have arrived at a conclusion that A minus A is even. So A minus A is even means AA belongs to R. Therefore, AA belongs to R. So, these two are similar elements. AA belongs to R. So, R is reflexive. R is reflexive. Or you can say reflexivity holds. The next one is symmetry. So for symmetry, consider AB belongs to R. Let AB belongs to R. So AB belongs to R means A minus B is even. A minus B is even means its negative is also even, means minus of A minus B is even, because as you know 4 is even, minus 4 is also even. So A minus B is even, so minus A minus B is also even. And minus A minus B means B minus A. So B minus A is even also. And B minus A is even, it means A minus B is even, AB belongs to R. B minus A is even means BA belongs to R. So what we have seen? AB belongs to R implies BA also belongs to R. So R is symmetry. And finally, we have to prove transitivity, means transitive. For transitive, consider two elements. Let AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R. AB belongs to R means, according to definition, AB belongs to R means A minus B is even and BC belongs to R means b minus c is even. Children, you know, sum of two even numbers is also even. Therefore, a minus b plus b minus c is also even. The value of a minus b plus b minus c should be a minus c because b and b should cancel. So a minus c is even. A minus c is even means ac belongs to r. So ab belongs to r, bc belongs to r, and we have seen ac belongs to r. Therefore r is transitive. R is transitive. So what we have seen, since R is reflexive, symmetry and transitive, so R is an equivalence relation. So R is an equivalence relation on Z. In this way we prove the questions. So let us see another question. So that the relation is parallel to, in the set of all straight lines in a plane is an equivalence relation. So consider S is the set of all straight lines in plane. And what is given? Given relation is, and relation is parallel to. This should be written as R L1, that is line 1, line 2, such that L1 is parallel to L2, and we have to prove that R is an equivalence relation. So for equivalence relation we will prove reflexive, symmetry and transitive. First see reflexive. Since every line is parallel to itself, because the angle between two parallel lines is either 0 degree or 180 degree. So you write here, since every line is parallel to itself, every line is parallel to itself. Therefore, line 1 is parallel to line 1. And see, line 1 parallel to line 2 means L1, L2 belongs to R. And we have seen here that L1 is parallel to L1 means line 1 is parallel to line 1. So it should be L1, L1 belongs to R. Therefore, L1, L1 belongs to R. So R is reflexive. Two similar element belongs here. R is reflexive. Second, symmetry. Symmetry. For symmetry, consider L1, L2 belongs to R. For all L1, L2 belongs to S. So L1, L2 belongs to R. According to question, L1 should parallel to L2. So L1 should parallel to L2. It is given. L1 is parallel to L2 means L2 is also parallel to L1. So we can say that L2, L1 also belongs to R. Hence L1, L2 belongs to R, and we have taken L1, L2 belongs to R and conclude that L2, L1 belongs to R. Therefore R is symmetry. The last one is transitive. So for transitive we consider two elements. Let L1, L2 belongs to R and L2, L3 also belongs to R. According to definition or condition, L1, L2 belongs to R means L1 is parallel to L2 and L2 is parallel to L3. So you can easily say line 1 is parallel to line 2 and line 2 is parallel to line 3. So line 1 must be parallel to line 3. Therefore L1 must be parallel to L3. And hence L1, L3 belongs to R. So it is transitive. Hence we have seen that R is reflexive, symmetry and transitive. Therefore R is an equivalence relation. On S. That is your result. See another question. So children, see the next question. Construct an example of relation which is reflexive and transitive but not symmetric. So you have to construct such type of relation which is reflexive, transitive but not symmetric. So let us see. Let A is equals to 1, 2, 3. A cross A, therefore A cross A should be written as 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3. Three one, three two, three three. And let R is equals to 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1 2 2 3 1 3. This is our construction. Now we will verify each point one by one. First see, since R is subset of A cross A, so R is a relation on A. R is a relation on A. First we have verified by example that R is a relation. Next, since 1 1 belongs to R, 2 2 belongs to R, 3 3 belongs to R. Hence R is reflexive. So this implies R is reflexive. Next see, since 1 2 belongs to R, but 2 1 does not belongs to R. Similarly, 2 3 belongs to R, 3 2 does not belongs to R, 1 3 belongs to R, but 3 1 is not belongs to R. So R is, this implies R is not symmetry. R is not symmetry. And finally we say that since 1 2 belongs to R, 2 3 belongs to R, and also 1 3 belongs to R. 1 2 belongs to R, 2 3 belongs to R, 1 3 also belongs to R. See the example. So R is transitive. That example verifies all the condition that R is reflexive and transitive, not symmetry. So we have verified first R is relation, then reflexive, then symmetry and transitive. So this is the example, hence the verified, or you may write proved. So these are the problems based on equivalence relation. Next day we will take the last class on the equivalence relation. If you have any query, you ask any question even after my WhatsApp also.